Now, I think it's pretty safe to say that when we examine two divisions over at Disney, both of which being Lucasfilm and Marvel Studios, they are equally as bad as far as exactly what's going on with the current slate of movies and or TV shows by, of course, Bob Iger, and how his cost containment plan, also known as his cost-cutting measures, are deeply impacting many of those upcoming projects and installments that are really in an ever-failing process. This is Mike Zero. Subscribe if you're new and like this video to see future updates. You can also follow me at MikeZero1. I thank you also very much for the great and kind support. So one thing about Bob Iger is that we know that he has been making all the wrong decisions for everything Marvel and handing it all down to Kevin Feige, right? Kevin Feige is in full agreement with Bob Iger's approach to upping the ante with DEI and diverting away from source material. That's why the 2025 lineup of movies, I feel, are going to be by far probably one of the worst additions of all time under the MCU. Now, what's interesting about all this has a lot to do with what's been going on with the current drama surrounding Deadpool 3. That's been an ongoing situation between those like Ryan Reynolds, Hugh Jackman, Rhett Reese and Paul Wernick, the writers, including director Sean Levy, all going up against Disney, and how there were various scenes that were cut that involved specific cameos from the MCU and even the SSU, also known as the Sony Spider-Man universe. But let's get into exactly what's going on with Tatiana Maslany and why she has a lot of problems with Ryan Reynolds behind the scenes, based on what happened with the character of She-Hulk getting axed and canceled from the third act of Deadpool 3 and scheduled reshoots for the spring. So on top of all of this, with all divisions at Disney beginning to fail ahead of 2025, one major development has much to do with the She-Hulk actress Tatiana Maslany behind the scenes for the Deadpool 3 film after she was fired and removed from all of her cameos as She-Hulk for the final act of the movie and for what was prepared for Ryan Reynolds. Now, one crucial update to the ongoing drama happening for the third Deadpool film is that Tatiana Maslany is willing to come forward with the general public about all the creative differences that she had with Ryan Reynolds on the set of Deadpool 3, and is something that she has been, of course, warning to Ryan Reynolds about coming forward with to the public. The warning was recently given to both Ryan and the creative team that she has serious issues with how She-Hulk was being portrayed by Kevin Feige and how they decided to cut out the character and Disney in the third act of Deadpool. This all comes in the wake of how Ryan was the one who made the call to fire Tatiana after, of course, he was given full liberty to do this by Disney after many negotiations and arguments that were being made between the creatives and the Disney heads. Now, this is why Tatiana holds issues with Ryan and is warning that she is ready to reveal the entire story of what happened behind the scenes of what She-Hulk's original scenes were going to entail in great depth, something that the creatives have been wanting to keep quiet. These heated arguments that took place between Tatiana Maslany and Reynolds, as it turns out, happened just after she was removed from the film and how it was Ryan's call to do so. The Disney heads and director Sean Levy left the decision up to Ryan, and this in turn created a divide between the two actors. Tatiana is the one who already warned Reynolds that she would also be willing to come forward with all the drama that's been going on with the third Deadpool film. A similar situation that happened with Aquaman 2, The Lost Kingdom with Amber Heard, when details of the drama between herself and Jason Momoa erupted for that film, were revealed eventually in great depth. Ever since Maslany was removed from practically all Marvel projects moving onwards for Phase 6 and 7, including Deadpool 3, which was her final acting gig for the years to come at Marvel Studios, this turned her to desperation. Reynolds, Rhett, Paul, and Sean are the ones who have been actively trying to keep She-Hulk from appearing in Deadpool after Disney made multiple moves to shoehorn her into the film. Many of the scenes were only written, however, some were either partially shot and or rehearsed, and even planned for the reshoots that would, of course, take place in spring. Tatiana is already creating a ruckus with Reynolds and demanding for her roles to be reinstated, or she is willing to go forward with her distant, of course, issues with the team and the production of Deadpool 3. Now, this should come as no surprise, since Tatiana was banking on this movie to be her major debut on the big screen for the Marvel Universe that would be considered a minor side character instead of a glorified cameo. Now, guys, let me just stop here for one moment before I move on. Now, the thing that Tatiana Maslany is so out of reach with is the fact that she has to come to terms with reality that things like this happen all the time. This is not the first time that this has happened in any studio within the film industry, let alone with Marvel Studios for an MCU film and or TV show. It happens all the time. Characters are cut, cameos are axed, it just happens. And I think that she has to begin to process that and accept it for what it is. So you have Ryan Reynolds, and we talked about this last week. He is the one that negotiated with Disney and really fell into a lot of arguments about how She-Hulk was being used in the film. They came to an agreement. They allowed Ryan to make the call on whether or not Tatiana should be given the boot. Ryan did make that call. She was not happy with him. And here we are. This is why there are tensions between the two actors. So look, Tatiana Maslany, at the same exact time, we know that she has attacked fans before in the past and is still doing that to this very day about her role in the She-Hulk TV series and all the drama surrounding She-Hulk Season 2 and the cancellation of the show, and how she believes that characters like Thor, Iron Man, and all the like need to be a moment in the past, and that characters like Ironheart need to be the future, alright? So that's what she really believes in. Moving on, alright, on top of this, she goes on to conclude in her overall scenario here with her whole squabble with Ryan Reynolds, is that in addition to all of this, Tatiana is also demanding the entire Deadpool team to include, of course, herself back into the production and Ryan to do the right thing by bringing her back in also for the planned reshoots. Tatiana was reportedly furious after Reynolds made the call to erase the entire fight between Wolverine and She-Hulk, where Wolverine gets defeated in an embarrassing way that was improvised by Kevin Feige and handed down to the writers, and originally scheduled for reshoots by late March into early April, which, by the way, guys, is just on the horizon. It's right around the corner, and Reynolds has been both unsuccessful and successful in these negotiations with Disney. We talked about this. There are some instances where Disney did cave, where they decided to pull back and not do anything with some scenes, but there are also other sequences that Disney remains very stubborn about. They want to enhance DEI in the third act of Deadpool 3. That's why there's this ongoing battle between the writers, the director, including Ryan, and even Hugh Jackman, one of the main stars, really going head-to-head against Disney to prevent those reshoots from even happening in the first place. And hey, it would be a blessing in disguise for Disney, at least it should be. I mean, it would be wasting less money to them, right? So why even pursue reshoots at this point? So I think I would love to hear what everyone has to say about this entire scenario below in the comments. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel, and I will catch you guys later.